What's up, guys? Back with another one. You know what it is. Today's gonna be a little bit different. We ain't gonna be doing anything on the car today. We're just gonna be talking about heat in the garage, man. Cause you know, that's like the most important thing right now. I'm here in Southern Maryland. It's 17 degrees outside. In my garage, it is about 38. So it's cold, too cold to be working on a car. It's just way too cold to be working on the car comfortably. So we're gonna get into this video, but before we do, subscribe, like this video, cause you know it's gonna be dope, and let's get into it. All right, so the two things we're gonna be talking about, or the two type of heaters today we're gonna be talking about, is the torpedo heater versus the propane like tank top heater, which we have right here. And now I do have an older version, but they all are the same. If you get a newer version, you know, this is a kerosene heater. You can get these in propane, and we'll talk about that. But this is the tank top heater that just goes on top of a 20-gallon propane tank. And they both heat up the room, but they are very different. So let's chill out and talk about that. All right, so here you can see we have both heaters. We have the tank top heater, and we have the torpedo heater. And I'm just gonna kind of leave it as basic as that. The torpedo heater you can get in propane. This one is kerosene. But let's go get into the pros and cons of both of them. So, as you can see, I wasted a little bit moving it, but this comes with a small cord that you can hook up to something. I need to get like a lead tail to make it better set up. All you do is just simply pretty much switch it on, and it'll cut on. And then for this heater, you can just get a lighter. You open up the valve for the propane to come out, and then you open up this as well, either turn on low or something, and then you push this is for the propane to get up to the heater, and then you just stick a match through here or something and light it, and it will stay lit as long as it has propane. So that's the difference between that. The pros for this, I think the biggest pro that this tank top heater has is you don't need electricity. So if you're a mobile mechanic or something like that, and you're working outside, all you need is this setup right here, boom, and you got yourself some nice, nice heat. Other pros about this is, you know, not since it's on top of a propane tank, they're easily interchangeable. Where I live, the first tank you get is like $40. You're pretty much paying for the tank, but the exchanges after that are about $20, so that's not bad. And it's just as easy and simple as screwing this, screwing on and screwing off for this portion of it and into the tank. Another good thing, it does have, a low, medium, and a high, so you can, adjust the amount of heat. That's a pretty good thing about it. And that's about it for these. The propane tank top heater, they heat up the spot pretty much, so you know, it's kind of like a radiant heat, so you'll get like a cloud of heat right here, which won't go too far, but it is a good amount of heat. This garage is about it's a two-car oversized garage. It can fit three cars in here comfortably. So like I said, this is like a pretty much a three-car garage. It's a two-car garage, but it's oversized, as you can see. Don't worry about the dash and stuff, but I got a car over there that can tuck way into the corner, and I can fit two cars right here. A big thing that you want to do if you're even looking to get a heater, is insulating your garage, which I have to do. I like to do this backside right here, and then I definitely need to do the garage doors. This is where most of the heat leaves, or most of the air comes in, and vice versa. And then I have
excuse me, I have like this little section right here that's not insulated right here either. This part right here is inside of my house, so I assume that's insulated. But you never know until you take the walls down, but you know, they usually insulate that so air or heat doesn't get into the house. This is just a like extension of the house. So yeah, that's that.
And this will heat up the space eventually. It does take a while, and that's the pretty much the con for this setup. So the con is, it doesn't, you know, project the heat. It's pretty much stagnant. So if you want to heat up a big space, it's going to take a while, probably like 30 minutes to an hour. But you know, if you're out in the yard or something like that, I rake leaves with this thing, man. I'm raking leaves and I come close to it, get warmed up, and then I'm back at it. So that's another con. You could just take this out in the yard if you're doing yard work and stuff like that, and you want to be out there for a while, and just take this with you. So yeah, I mean, it's a good setup, especially if you're mobile. It's a great setup. But if you want to heat up a garage or something big and you want to do it fast, I would direct you into the Torpedo heater. So pros on the Torpedo heater, it will heat up a room fast as long as you have enough BTUs. It is electric, so you know, for the electric controls the fan. The electric controls the fan and the, you know, spark and stuff like that. So you do have that. Another pro is this thing gets hot, gets really hot. So that's always a good thing. It does take kerosene, like I said. So depending on if you like doing that swap out, you know, you could just buy, you know, if you're at home, you could buy, you know, 10, 20 gallons of kerosene and have it on hand. You won't have to go out, swap tanks as much and stuff like that. All right, so this thing has been, and I'm being kind of loud because I know it's in the background. This thing has been running for like 30 to 45 minutes maybe, probably not even that much. And we're gonna go back over to the thermometer. Obviously, we're cooking with grease. To the cons of this Torpedo heater, I personally don't like swapping out the kerosene or buying kerosene over and over, you know. I usually do 1 to 2 gallons at a time. You spill it and stuff like that, it's kind of a hassle. But that can be alleviated if you can get a propane, one that hooks up to a propane tank. And that's just awesome. That's what I want to do. This one was free for me. So when I upgrade, I will be getting one with a propane tank. And if you get that, besides the portability of this, this beats the tank top heater out if you're that, you know, at home in your garage by far. Just think I heat my garage up in no time. It'll probably get me up to 70 degrees here in about 15 minutes. Whereas this will take probably an hour or so to get me up to 70 degrees. This one will have me sweating and I'll have to turn it off eventually. And then sometimes I just use this to keep the heat kind of, you know, in the area without having to plug this in. So I would definitely, if you got a garage space and you're not looking to do electric, like an electric heater, I would definitely go with a Torpedo heater with a propane tank. But if you are mobile, I would definitely go with the tank top with the propane tank. You can't really go wrong with either one. They're priced around the same. But if you're going to be working in your garage most of the time and that's your main intent for using it, go with the Torpedo. That's all I really have to say about that. If you got any questions, comment down below. Hopefully you like this video. Like, comment, subscribe, and peace. All right, guys, that's it, man. You could just, it's crazy. You can see anywhere I go, I have adequate lighting for the camera, for the vlog, which is awesome. All right, man. So these are definitely a must buy. They were only $50, so I paid $100 for 12.